Hello viewers, in chapter circulatory system we are coming across many terms related to blood, blood vessels and heart. Let us learn the terminologies and the definitions related to these terms. Blood is the fluid connective tissue. It is composed of plasma and foam elements. Plasma is the fluid part that constitutes 55%, and foam elements are the cells or the cellular elements, that is a 45%, which includes erythrocytes means RBC, leukocytes means WBC, and thrombocytes means platelets. Plasma, it is composed of water, proteins, inorganic salts and other substances. Water constitutes 90%, protein is of 8%. The plasma proteins are known as albumin, globulin, fibrinogen. Inorganic salts include sodium chloride and sodium bicarbonate, that is a 1%. Other substances include nutrients, hormones and urea, that is a 1%. Serum, blood plasma from which the protein fibrinogen is removed. Fibrinogen is the soluble plasma protein. Defibrinated blood, blood minus fibrin means fibrin, which is insoluble plasma protein, that is removed from the blood. Hemoglobin, it is composed of hemin and globin. Hemoglobin is a respiratory pigment that constitutes the iron part known as hemin, and the globin is the protein part. Oxyhemoglobin, it is composed of hemoglobin and oxygen. It is an unstable compound, means hemoglobin can be dissociated from oxygen. Carboxyhemoglobin, it is composed of carbon monoxide and hemoglobin. Carboxyhemoglobin is a stable compound where carbon monoxide, if once bound with hemoglobin, this cannot be separated. Carbaminohemoglobin, it is composed of carbon dioxide and hemoglobin. So carbaminohemoglobin is an unstable compound, means hemoglobin can be separated from carbon dioxide. Pus, it is a thick fluid that constitutes killed leukocytes, means WBCs, along with destroyed tissue cells and germs. The germs may be bacteria, may be fungus. Lymph, part of the blood serum which is colorless, and this fluid contains white blood cells, and this fluid bathes the tissues and ultimately that drains through the lymphatic system and joins with the blood circulation. Inflammation, it is a localized reaction that produces redness, warmth, swelling and pain as a result of infection. Diapedesis, it is the process of squeezing out of white blood cells, means WBCs, through the wall of capillaries into the surrounding tissues. When there is an invasion of the foreign bodies, immediately WBCs move out of the blood, and the process is known as diapedesis. Phagocytosis, the process of engulfing and ingestion of foreign bodies by phagocytes. The phagocytes are neutrophils and monocytes. These are the types of white blood cells. Vasoconstriction, vaso means vessel, constriction means contraction. So the contraction of the blood vessels. Here the capillaries are thin walled, that's why the capillaries are contracted and the condition is known as vasoconstriction. Vasodilation means widening of the capillaries. Blood transfusion, the process of transfer of blood from the donor to the recipient, that means from the vein to vein the transfer of the blood occurs. Agglutination, the process of formation of clumps of cells by specific antibodies to surface antigenic components, that means the antibodies are attached to the antigens as if they are attached with the help of glue, they cannot be separated. Anticoagulants, the substances which prevent clotting of blood, example is heparin. Heparin is found inside the blood vessels which prevents blood clotting inside the body. Homeostasis, maintenance of the internal environment constant, means the composition of the body fluids remains constant. Myocardial infarction, it is a condition known as heart attack and it occurs when there is a blockage in any coronary artery. Coronary artery is the thin artery that supplies oxygenated blood to the cardiac muscles and it leads to the deadening of the corresponding area of the heart muscles due to deprivation of oxygen. Due to blockage in the coronary artery, sufficient oxygen cannot reach to the cardiac muscles. That leads to the deadening of the cardiac muscles. Angina pectoris, chest pain due to insufficient supply of blood to the heart muscle. Hemorrhage, it is known as internal bleeding or clotting of blood. Hemophilia, a sex-linked disease characterized by failure of the blood to clot. As it is genetic, it cannot be cured. It is also known as bleeder's disease. Hypertension, a condition in which the force of the blood against the wall of the artery is very high. It is also known as high blood pressure. Polycythemia, abnormally increased number of RBCs. Erythropoietin, if the number of RBCs are decreased, then normal. Leukemia, abnormal increase in the number of WBCs. Leukopenia, abnormal decrease in the number of WBCs. Anemia, a condition in which there is a deficiency of red blood cells, means erythrocytes, or there is deficiency of hemoglobin in the blood. Systole, the contraction phase of the heart, means the auricles and the ventricles, when they contract, the phase is called systole. Diastole, relaxation phase of the heart. Heartbeat, it is the time taken by one systole followed by immediate diastole of the heart. Lub, it is the fast long booming sound produced by the closure of the auriculoventricular valves. It is called the fast heart sound. Dub, the second short sharp sound produced due to the closure of semilunar valves. It is called the second heart sound. Cardiac cycle, the whole sequence of events in the heartbeat. Double circulation, the circulation of blood into the chambers of the heart twice during one complete circulation. Pulmonary circulation, the blood circulation between the heart and lungs. The blood circulation that arises from the right ventricle and ends in left auricle. Systemic circulation, the blood circulation between the heart and the rest of the body. So the blood circulation arises from the left ventricle and that ends in right auricle. Blood pressure. Pressure exerted by blood on the walls of the arteries. It is measured with the help of sphygmomanometer. Systolic pressure. The pressure of blood inside the artery during ventricular systole. Diastolic pressure. The pressure of blood in artery during ventricular diastole. Pulse. The alternate expansion and elastic recoil of the wall of the artery during ventricular systole. Hope you have learned these terms. Write these for practice so that you can recall whenever there is requirement. Meet you in the next video. Thank you.